This is a production of WKNO Memphis. Production funding for Behind the Headlines is made possible in part by the WKNO Production Fund, the WKNO Endowment Fund, and by viewers like you. Thank you.
The battle over school consolidation continues as a court ruling sets in motion a citywide referendum. But could a compromise between the city and county or legislation moving through Nashville stop that vote? Plus, Mayors Wharton and Luttrell propose a plan to streamline their efforts to bring new businesses to the community. Those stories and more coming up on Behind the Headlines. Good evening, I'm Eric Barnes, publisher of the Memphis Daily News, and welcome to Behind the Headlines. Before we get to this week's stories, let me introduce our panel. First, Bill Dries from the Memphis Daily News, Les Smith, Fox 13 News, Amos Mackey from the Commercial Appeal, and Jackson Baker from the Memphis Flyer. Welcome. Bill, we're going to start with you with the schools, and we were joking that you were joking with me that you had written two or three stories this week that were obsolete before they were even posted to the web, that you couldn't even use them because things were moving so fast. And one of the things that I was struck by all week long was there were so many developments, and each development was, the ramifications were almost unclear and more confusion even as things move forward. Why don't you start with the court ruling that came down and where that puts us, and we'll go into some of the other angles on this.
Okay, the agreement in court is that there is going to be a referendum on a Memphis City Schools charter surrender. That election is most likely going to be March 8th, which is the date that's already on the calendar for a special election in State House District 98. The Election Commission will do the honors on Wednesday to officially set the date. Early voting will begin about February 15th. This is essentially the Tennessee Election Coordinator, which had directed the Election Commission not to set an election just 1 week earlier, basically caved and said, yeah, there's got to be an election, and directed the Election Commission to go ahead and set this election. So the election is on its way to the ballot.
But meanwhile, we've got talk of a compromise between the city school system and the county school system to hold off for a year or so. Talk to me about the compromise, and it's unclear what that means.
Well, it's unclear if you look at the terms if it's even really a compromise. This is something that has come from the Shelby County School Board, which reached out to the attorney for the Memphis City School Board, Dorsey Hobson, and said, we got something, will you talk to your clients about it? And Dorsey Hobson did it at a board work session on Thursday. Basically, now that the city school system, which approved the resolution that made this referendum possible, now that they're about to get it, the county school board has come to them and said, well, wait a minute, why don't you rescind that resolution, agree to appoint a committee that will study consolidation as well as a special school district for us for at least 18 months, and agree that whatever that committee comes up with will be binding on you and us, and that if by chance they do recommend school consolidation, that it will be a countywide vote and not a city of Memphis vote.
Jackson, I mean, why, after the city school board voted to go forward with this surrender just weeks ago, why are they even considering pulling back?
Well, they're getting some pressure. The MEA had a meeting last week.
The teachers.
Memphis Education Association, actually earlier this week, in which there were a lot of people saying we need more information. We can't rush into this. And, of course, the opponents of surrendering the charter are making this point. That's a wedge issue for them. What is really bizarre is the school board voted last night to have a meeting next week, same week in which the Election Commission will meet, to decide to hear out the terms of this plan and consider what to do with it. I suppose they could fast-track it, suspend the rules, and vote on it that very night, although in theory they're going to have a second meeting after that. But what if they meet on Tuesday night? They haven't set a date yet. They meet on Tuesday night and they decide, well, let's vote on this plan. Let's rescind our vote, which means they unlock, they disarm themselves. Their weapon they put down, can't use it again. Meanwhile, the county still has their guns cocked and loaded.
Guns cocked and loaded, partly in the sense that there is legislation in the...
They've agreed only to delay their bills, which would include, down the line, a special school district bill, possibly.
Let's clarify. The legislation is a bill put forward by Mark Norris from Collierville, a senator, yes. A very powerful Republican senator in the state legislature. He put forward a bill that would essentially call for a compromise, a one-year stand down. Is that right?
He's forced behind this bill as well. His bill is already passed by first reading, but that's a routine thing in the legislature. If it goes forward to a second and third reading, it gets very serious. He's going to hold it back for a little while.
Yeah. Les.
And then you talk about fast track. Then there's this entirely different entity out there called the Citizens for Better Education, who are really responsible for pushing through on this whole referendum idea and getting it to court. They are going on as if, okay, we're now pointed towards a referendum. They've already established a website. This is a group that came into being, as we know it, last Friday. As we were sitting here last Friday, they were being introduced. Maxine Smith, a couple of civil rights icons, Russell Sugarman, a number of councilmen, a number of legislators, all involved in this group. And so they're now in it, pushing this referendum, completely separate of any kind of deals right. being made by the school
and
boards.
And they're a group who wants this to pass.
Who wants the city to surrender its charter and pass control of the school system over to the school system.
So the anomaly is, if the school board should totally reverse itself and say we're going to rescind our vote, in fact, we love the idea of a special school district, the referendum apparently still goes forward. Mm-hmm. And the election commission is really in a quandary if this happens before Wednesday. It probably won't. They'll probably postpone their meeting until after the referendum is set, which gives the city a little bit more leverage back.
Or the third choice here is the school board could say, no, these terms are way too harsh for a school board that has the upper hand, but they could conceivably make a counter mm-hmm. offer on it.
To delay in some way or hold off.
Or to say, we can't live with these terms, but we can live with these terms. What do you think about that? And meanwhile, the election goes ahead. At any rate, you know, Mark Norris in his letter saying that he didn't think his legislation warranted further action, he said that there had been an agreement in principle to these terms. Whatever you think of what the vote was at the school board meeting on Thursday night, there is not an agreement in principle. There is an agreement to discuss the terms,
right.
But there's not an agreement in principle right. on this at all.
It's an odd proposal in that it basically takes away the ability for Memphis City Schools and city voters to determine what they want to do because mm-hmm. they want to allow people outside of Memphis in the county to vote on this issue. It's almost absurd.
Because from a leverage point of view, it releases their leverage. I think
yeah,
so.
Yeah, I mean, like Mark Norris, when he was on the county, he did not want city voters to vote in county school board elections. Well, now he wants to let county voters vote right. in this Memphis City Schools issue. That's being for it before he was against it.
Jackson.
And from the city's point of view, the city board's point of view, there's one more flaw in this plan. It's a fatal flaw because the plan calls for equal numbers of people appointed to this team, which will determine what the referendum is. And they're balanced. We know the county people are going to be against consolidation. And then the two superintendents, we know that Kreiner Cash, like his counterpart in the county, is going
right.
to be against consolidation
right.
too. It's a dead number
deal.
For the city. Yeah.
Right.
Let's go back to the legislation that Mark Norris put forward that was getting some attention all week, and he outlined what his legislation called for, and it is he has held up on it. It's not moving forward as of this moment, but the legislation could radically change the whole conversation and the whole course of things.
Right. The Norris bill, Senate Bill 25, basically takes the Planning Commission to come up with a consolidation transition that is in other legislation on schools consolidation and would apply it to this situation. What that amounts to is a process for consolidation that would take approximately a year in order to work itself out and go to voters on a ballot. And then the ballot would be actually what we have for the Metro Charter. Votes in the city of Memphis and a separate vote in the county outside
of
Memphis.
That, at the end of the day, if the Norris bill passed, you would have a year or so from now, the city would go, they would vote. If the city voted yes, a majority of city voters vote yes, but a majority of county voters vote no, it wouldn't happen. Both
it would
not
happen.
It would not. You don't combine the votes. You don't pool the votes. It's two separate votes.
Yes. Yeah.
And that was on the fast track. There was a first reading or three readings of this.
Right.
And it was on a fast track.
It's still theoretically on the fast track. Norris's statement didn't say he was withdrawing the legislation.
Right.
He said that he didn't think that it warranted further action given the agreement
go ahead.
In principle.
He has come under heavy criticism from city council members and earlier this week county commission members for essentially, I mean, he argued Memphis voters should not have a say in county school board elections, okay? These books, the laws on these types of transfer of power, surrender of the charter, they have been on the books for years and years and years and years. Then all of a sudden, when Memphis wants to use these laws that have been on the books for all these years, people want to change the rules of the game. They want to speed this legislation through the General Assembly, not with the whole support of the Shelby County delegation, but just with the support of the Republicans. The County Commission passed a resolution earlier this week criticizing Mr. Norris just for that.
The County Commission did.
Yes, yeah, just for that very reason.
Okay, now let's say for playing this out, that the Norris bill goes forward, it gets passed quickly on the fast track that he's talked about and that Beth Harwell, the new speaker of the state house, has said. That gets passed, that puts a law down that says, okay, there are new rules to play by to do this. And yet there's a referendum underway.
You can have two laws saying totally
different things. So I don't understand what happens.
Well,
we need a staff lawyer to sort this out.
Jackson is correct. You have at least two laws saying different things, but you have a court order from Chancery Court that Alan Wade would rely on that says these are the terms of this election. This is what this court has ordered. And Wade believes that that court order means that whatever happens in the legislature, it cannot change the nature of this referendum and that it would remain a citywide vote and a vote of City of Memphis.
And Alan Wade, who's the attorney who in this case is representing the group you were talking about.
He's doing pro bono service for the Citizens for Better Education group.
So you would essentially have to get another court to overrule what a court has already established and approved.
Right.
And the wording is already there. We know what the wording would be.
Well, let's talk about that for a second, because we're pretty wrapped up in the details of this.
Sure.
And there are probably a lot of people watching this who are going, what is it that I'm about to be asked to vote
right.
on? And that is a very important consideration here. It's not a whole lot of it's not a detailed plan like the Metro Charter proposal was. It's a very simply worded proposition, but the wording is still critical. And Memphis Mayor A.C. Wharton talked about that earlier this week about the importance of this.
Because right now the only thing that's going to be on the ballot is, shall we surrender our schools? Now, I researched this yesterday. I'm no longer practicing law, so it might not be worth anything. But I don't think the statute allowing the surrender actually prescribes, as distinguished from the case with the consolidation vote, I don't think it actually spells out what has to be on the ballot. So this may be, it could be that something good comes out, because the question could possibly read, should the Memphis City School System surrender its charter and, in lieu of the present system, have this system which will guarantee equitable funding forever. Now, that's a good thing to put on the ballot, but simply to say, shall we give up the charter and just, what are we going to have after that? I don't know. See, what happens when you do that? It turns the election into one of the most base. It's going to bring out the worst. It's going to bring out fear, and it's going to be race. It's going to be recrimination and everything. But if you put something on there, what are we going to get? And people are voting for a known item.
That's a quote from when AC was on this show about a month ago, and what we ended up with, the language that I think the Election Commission has agreed on in the to go on the referendum is, shall the, in effect, you know, shall the Memphis City Schools transfer authority for the school system over to the Shelby County school
Correct.
System. It doesn't mention surrender the charter, and that was a big, is a detailed point. It didn't, what didn't happen is what Mayor Wharton asked for, you know, a more positive kind of message to be put on there. That really didn't, isn't what's come to pass.
On the other hand, the city council is going to meet Tuesday, and it could still pass a resolution calling for the surrender of the charter.
They could. That's highly unlikely. In situations like this, council members really don't like sticking their neck out, making a vote on a controversial issue like this when you can let the public do it. And that's what we'll see.
The distinction between turning over authority for the school system and surrendering the charter is a distinction that the election coordinator's office made. It's a distinction that the attorney for the city school system recognizes but really has not addressed. When the elections coordinator said, clarify what you mean by, is this a surrender of the charter or is this a transfer of authority, the city school system's attorney, Mike Marshall, sent a letter back saying the resolution speaks for itself, put this on the ballot.
Going back to the question you asked, you know, so people are wondering, you know, if this early voting starts in a couple of weeks, what am I voting on? What that would mean in essence, I mean, correct me, anyone, if I'm wrong, is very quickly, I mean, the Memphis City school system would dissolve, and the county school system, the county school superintendent, the county school board would be in charge of the Memphis City schools. There'd be a transition process that they've talked about and they're beginning to plan for that could take months. I mean, it's not as if kids won't go to school the next day kind of thing. But in terms of authority, the Memphis City School Board goes away.
If there are some things we know, if that does happen, for instance, the county commission would be able to redistrict the new combined school system. It's still unclear how many school board members you would have to have or when they would be elected.
Or if
they would be appointed. Right. What happens to the current county school board members? Do they finish out their terms to 2012 and 2014? But yes, essentially, Shelby County Schools would be responsible for administrating Memphis City Schools.
Yeah. And all of that came up this
sure
week
did.
When they had the introduction of the ad hoc redistricting.
Right.
That's a hard word to say, isn't it? Even harder to do. And Chairman Walter Bailey of the Shelby County Commission. And it was more or less the same things we've all talked about. You know, what happens if, how many members are going to sit on the board? Should we do anything right now? And it turned out in kind of a, like, Tower of Babel kind of thing. I mean, it was just everybody talking. Kelly Rain, who is the county attorney, tried to answer their questions based on an interpretation of what she knew from the law, but all of these things that she kept saying, you know, this is uncharted territory. We don't really know.
So there's a lot of gray areas. Some of the stuff is contradictory.
Right.
Some of it is clear. You know, county commission would redistrict eventually.
That's right. Interesting parties who was there, very interested party, was John Aiken, who is, of course, the Shelby County Superintendent. This is all going to fall in his lap. It's headed that way. So we were there, and this is the way that things kind of went that day.
You couldn't blame devout Elvis Presley fan and Shelby County School Superintendent John Aiken from striking a pose like he just inherited ownership of Heartbreak Hotel. Aiken's anxiety level probably wasn't helped as he sat through a perplexing meeting of a Shelby County Commission's ad hoc committee on redistricting that tried to focus on answers about school consolidation.
I think probably the one thing that I did not know is that the level of lack of knowledge is prevalent around. I mean, quite honestly, I mean, it's everywhere.
Process alone.
With veteran Shelby County Commissioner Walter Bailey thankfully leading the way as group chairman, his colleagues listened as County Attorney Kelly Rain tried to provide legal interpretations on what the commission would be facing if a Memphis City Schools charter surrender referendum proved successful with voters.
Utilize the state law provision that transfers
the school control to the county school board upon a referendum of the voters in the city of Memphis.
While Bailey warned the group to stay clear for now of moving toward any specific planning about redrawing district lines or reapportionment, one consolidation issue drew the most interest, even if it was confined to only conjecture. 7, 9, 13, 23, just how many board members will it take to rule over a merger of city and county schools? And what do you do with the current school board members? Well, through no fault of her own, sometimes Raines' answers to committee questions were as clear-cut as if they came from a Ouija board.
The question here is, if you redistrict, what happens to those folks in office and how many seats could this body create? Because, again, you're required to create districts of substantially equal population.
This takes effect.
Try to find the specific answer in that reply, huh? But nonetheless, some committee members agree the issue of how many should sit on a potential combined board should be a top priority to ensure county commissioners won't be stuck with their heads in the sand if the referendum passes.
Whether you're for this or against this, if people are afraid of chaos, we ought to be able to reassure them that there is an orderly transition plan in place.
Whether you think they should be brought together or not, if they are brought together, surely bringing into place an elected representative school board as soon as possible is in everybody's interest.
There are just so many unanswered questions.
There are. And after this was kind of nearing its end, Commissioner Mike Ritz put in an appeal, and he said basically, okay, let's talk about, I think it's going to be important that we lay down a foundation of who's going to be on the school board and how big it's going to be. That is what people really need to know. And so I think that's kind of the way that they're going to be heading with this ad hoc committee, rather than talking about drawing lines or anything else. As for its size, well, you were there, and, mm-hmm. and Commissioner Wyatt Bunker had a suggestion.
He and Chris Thomas, and it's kind of something former Mayor Harrington has talked about before, is possibly breaking up, you know, Memphis City Schools or this new combined school district into smaller, more manageable areas. Mm-hmm. So maybe you would have 5 or 6 different zones mm-hmm. that are all controlled by this new unified school system, but that way it's not just so big and so unwieldy that they can't control it or get any results out of it. But I mean, that's a long way down the road from where we are now. But people, you know, I think some parents do worry. Some people moved out of the city and into the county just for the schools. Those are major life decisions.
And that gets to the real fear that people have, that somehow the problems in some city schools are suddenly just going to come rushing out
right.
into these counties. And you hear really inflammatory things being said about, I'm going to have to move to Fayette County, or I'm going to have to move to Mississippi, and so
some
on.
Some of it's kind of absurd. I mean, yeah. This is like when I lived in Atlanta and there was talk of extending the subway system out to the suburbs, and people worried about crime.
Right.
And it's kind of the same thing here.
Last comment from Jackson.
You know, nobody anticipates any transfer of populations like what happened with
right.
busing.
Right.
Neighborhood schools, one way or another, going to be the keystone of this.
Right. Nobody anticipates that, but we're talking about parents of children who were children when that considerable amount of turmoil happened.
Right. The vote,
and,
yes.
And there is there is what is rational, and there's also the other things that are rattling around in
right.
your head when something like this
All right.
comes
well,
up.
We will come back to this story next week, I'm sure there'll be more developments and perhaps a little more clarity on where things are going. We're going to transition into, there is actually other news. The mayors, Wharton and Luttrell, proposed, move forward with a plan that have been talked about to streamline the economic development efforts of the city. The city and county. Why don't you talk about that for a second, Bill?
It's called EDGE. They've been talking about this for a long time. It's basically a quasi-governmental entity to really be the voice on economic development in Memphis and Shelby County, a unified voice that will also take in several bodies that you have now, including the Industrial Development Board, a body which grants pilots, which are tax breaks for companies looking to relocate here. The body would be, while it would report to the mayors, it would not be a department or division of city government. It would be more outside of government, than it is inside of government.
And it would include the Industrial Development Board, as you mentioned, but the Port Commission, the Depot, the right. Industrial Park where Electrolux right. is moving in. And some of this came about, it was talked about in the context of Electrolux, the big appliance maker who's putting in a huge plant down in the Pigeon Industrial Park.
It's been a long-going problem. You had a Port Commission for a long time. That's why you didn't see a lot of development down there in Pigeon Industrial Park. You had a Port Commission that didn't like to sell its real estate because that would effectively put them out of business. They didn't want to give real estate brokers commissions. It was kind of its own, I mean, Nucor Steel, $250 million plant, one of the most sought after companies right. in the world, almost gave Memphis the middle finger and said, we're out of here.
Right.
Because the Port Commission wouldn't do the right thing on dredging the port. So it creates this new body, streamline operations, and with one goal in mind. Let's get the job done. You know, I think a lot of times people in business feel that people in government are way too quick to say no or to say this can't be done. Right. And I it seems to me this would be a way where the mayors would be able to pick up the phone, you talk to one guy in charge,
right.
say we get this done no matter
and
what.
And Wharton has talked about how Memphis competes against DeSoto County in this way, and DeSoto County has this sort of streamlined setup where you call one person and they can put together a package of incentives, talk to the various people, and that Memphis has just been at a competitive disadvantage, not only nationally, but to its neighbor, and
right.
we lost some businesses that moved across the border because of that, because it's just simpler. And
right.
so the mayor's really made a priority of this. But it'll be interesting to see where it goes, because it's going to require, I believe, city council approval in some ways and county commission approval. We'll end it there. We'll probably talk more about this. We've
right.
spent a great deal of time on the schools. Thank you all for being here. Thank you for joining us. Please join us next week for another edition of Behind the Headlines. Go to WKNO.org in the meantime to stay up with us. Thanks and good night.